9-7.
All right. Back in action.
10-7. MSU up. Shot clock resets. Assistant captain Austin Morley goes out with a shot to the foot. We got a freshman protecting him. Grand Valley goes on to the 10 count. 10-5. Doesn't reset the shot clock. Good news is he got out of the play as well, so he's back in now since the shot clock violation was called before he got hit. So MSU has the player advantage, the ball advantage, and they still have a lot of time here. 12 minutes left on the clock. Balls, 10 players. Captain Kevin Bailey stays alive. Dodges three balls. He sets the shot clock, runs back. Should be looking for a catch here. Second year, Aaron Van Glitteren, he took one to the face, but he came up with a catch. Grand Valley out to 6 players. Kevin resets the sack back, looking to get the ball back. Doesn't get it. Grand Valley now 6 players. Back on the 15 shot clock. He can stay still at 7 balls. They have a huge ball advantage, still have the player advantage. Short throw by Britt Skinner. Still 3-7 balls. one thing about MSU. They don't like to give up their ball control if they have it. Bailey's making a lot of throws here. It's only two games in this tournament, so his arm strength should be okay, but they should start considering letting other people throw. MSU's not going to give them any more than three balls. They want to keep the advantage so they can team throw on others. Short throw. The official allows it. Up to four balls now. Gambrell has four balls. Michigan State has six. Still a 9-on-6 Michigan State advantage. Solo throw. Gets caught by MSU. Gets caught. McCoy, one to Jen, number 22, Grand Valley. Brings it to 8-on-7. MSU slowly losing their advantage. West Peters looking for a catch there. Didn't get to him. Two graduate students at the line. Tony Stumble, Wes Peters. A lot more experience on the court for MSU right now. Play throw by West Peters. Good block. Stay there. At some point, they're going to have to try something different than the single throw. They're getting caught. Grand Valley's just comfortable sitting on the back line making some catches. Grand Valley's up to, now they have four balls, but it's MSU, so. So the ball control has been knocked down. It's basically even now. MSU has a slight advantage. One ball advantage. Count. 5. Grand Valley has a ball advantage, but they are on the 10 count here. They're going to be looking at making a long throw. Kinds of throws. A lot of inexperience out there with him, so he feels the need to take all the throws in order to not get caught. Throwing catches right now would be Kevin catches short. Grand Valley, Joel Brzezinski throws a catch. Timeout, Grand Valley. Timeout, Grand Valley. So 4-on-9. Kevin Bailey and 3 second-year players versus most of MSU's team. Not sure who got caught in on the catch there, but if Captain Colin O'Brien got caught in, that's a huge swing for the MSU Spartans. Grand Valley should be looking for some catches here. Got to get their numbers back up. They can't expect Kevin to make all the throws he's already made. Probably close to 40 throws today. Like Colin O'Brien is not in, which is significant for Grand Valley. He's an excellent catcher and basically their general on the court. Well placed throw out of reach there. Right now their goal, MSU's goal, is to take away the balls from Grand Valley so they can get a proper team throw. They don't want to throw any catches here because that will bring another player in, and also the new rule this year, it will reset their shot clock as well. I mean, the 10 second count. James Reyes throws a catch to graduate student Wes Peters. It's now 9-on-3. MSU has a clear advantage of players. Grand Valley needs to stop making so many long throws. That's where they're getting caught. Minutes left in the half. Can Grand Valley hold on? Hey. GVSU is feeling the clock counting down on them. They're wasting almost all their balls trying to get out these cranberry plays. To make two throws to ensure the shot clock is reset. Four balls. Everyone has a blocking ball. Looking good for Grand Valley. MSU should have been playing with this pace 10 minutes ago. Seconds. There's no way that MSU is gonna pull this out. As long as Kevin's got a ball in his hand, he's not gonna get. Half ends 0-0. MSU went up early with the man advantage, the ball advantage, but they just slowed the game way down. And they didn't play fast enough to get everyone out in time. That's one of their main problems. They can't play fast. It's gonna hurt them. They need to figure out how to play with a quicker pace and not be confused. They wanna take this game. Second half, about to get underway here. MSU versus GVSU, 0-0 at the half. First half, MSU went up early. They got, I think, three people out on the run-up, so that was pretty significant, and a lot of the balls. They played real slow the whole game, though, and were unable to finish off Grand Valley to take the point. So, clean slate here, 15-15. MSU has the confidence, I believe, to take the point and the game. But we will see if they have the pace. Grand Valley kind of got a reality check there. Right off the bat, they know they got to play faster and smarter if they want to defeat this MSU team, who's hungry, since they have never beat Grand Valley in the history of their program. I believe the series is 36-0 Grand Valley, all-time lead. Looks like one player from each side went out. Number 11 for GVSU, Steve Snyder, and number 1 from MSU. By assistant captain Aaron Frenzy. apparently Galvanax likes to get up close and personal with the opposite team, make close throws, often leaves them trapped in the middle, neutral zone though. He needs to watch that. We're looking at 14-14 still. MSU has three balls, two balls now. Grand Valley has a ball control. Austin Morley gets a foot shot there. Long throw. Looks like a freshman player, MSU, gets caught. MSU is looking confused. Big throw by Andrenzi. Still only have three balls. Playing on the back line, they can't do much when they have three balls. Long throws are going to be what kills MSU. They already got caught once this point from the long throw. Even counts, both teams through the same time. Trenzi gets caught, put the ball a little too high there, put it right into the chest of number 66 for MSU. Down goes number 33 for Grand Valley. Takes a shot to his foot. MSU has two balls. Long throw. Not a great spot, but luckily he doesn't get caught. MSU, a lot better job with their balls depth. No, he's getting lucky there. It's a shot that Kevin usually hits. A lot faster play here this half. Both teams want. They know how important taking this first point will be, since there was 0 points scored last half. This may be the deciding point. Looks like 12 on 12. Long throw again by Noe. Six balls for Grand Valley, four for MSU. Long throw by second year player McCoy Wonderdem. Gets caught by MSU's captain. Not sure what the call was there. I thought Town clearly caught the ball. McCoy comes back in after stepping. needed some help there. Couldn't get it. Took a shot to the shin by Kevin Bailey. Balls now, MSU. Shot clock should really be. Still only two balls. No, he's gonna make a long throw here. Assistant captain Austin Morley tries to make a diving catch and misses it. It's a big loss. Kelly gets hit in his leg. They lose a big arm there, but it might work out in MSU's advantage that he didn't throw a catch because he was making a lot of long throws there. Two balls is big job by Colin O'Brien. Grand Valley has player advantage, ball advantage. Looking for catches here to get back into this point. Number 11 from MSU goes out after getting caught in the neutral zone. MSU got five balls out of the transaction now. MSU goes down looking for a catch. Six on ten. Grand Valley has the man advantage. MSU is looking content just to reset the shot clock at that point. I don't think they know what to do. Well-timed cross at number 18. Just misses a Grand Valley player. Number 66 on MSU makes a key catch. 7-on-9 is a player catch here. Looks like it got him on the foot. Yep, ref's calling him out. Go, 6-on-8. Grand Valley. short throw. They wait till the last second and put the throw short. MSU gets all the balls. It was a bad throw. Look for MSU's hard throwers, number 66 and 27, to make throws here. Possibly 25 as well. Single throw, number 25, all the way across the court. Not a great play. If Kevin Bailey was looking for it, he easily could have caught the ball. Kevin Bailey has two balls now. MSU's going to look to slow play this again. MSU looking to throw at Bailey. He's the only one with the ball on his hand, so he can get a clean block on it. They need to look at throwing someone without a ball if they want to end this point. One throw and a ball's over. Not a great strategy. Refs are doing a pretty good job at this point. Besides that, questionable no catch. Not really sure what happened there. Number 59 on Grand Valley gets hit in his side at looking at the first ball that was thrown to him. It's now 7-6. Grand Valley have one person advantage. Two long throws by MSU. Luckily, none of them got caught. Bailey looking to reset the shot clock and get the ball back. Doesn't work. Teams look like they're trying to pick out some younger players here to get out to set the other team on the 10-second shot clock. Look for Kevin to throw the one big guy without a ball. He's on 10 second shot clock. Five people left against seven for Grand Valley. Long throw by Zajac, number 27 on the seal. Good block. Good team effort there by 81 for Grand Valley. Anthony Iconic. Good block for his freshman partner. Good help by MSU to keep Kevin Bailey on his heels there. Doesn't want to push up too far. They don't want to get caught in the neutral zone here. But it's... They make two throws there because the first one was short. Looks for a catch and drops it. 6-on-5. Grand Valley one man advantage and a two ball advantage. Catch or hit. Number 66 makes a catch. Looks like he stepped out there, but the ref calls him safe. He makes a switch. Six to five the other way, MSU. With six. Looks like a freshman player got caught in for MSU. Probably the main thing that we did there was just take them off the 10-second cap. Got some back and forth going between the teams here. Not sure what about. I thought that was a good throw. They allowed it. Yeah. Alright, starting back up. MSU 6 players and 5 balls. They should be 0 seconds on the shot clock. Grand Valley has 5 players, 4 balls, 6, 5 balls, 5 balls. 5 balls, 5 balls. Seven minutes left. Still anyone's game. MSU forces number 81 to Grand Valley to block a thrown ball, and the consequence being he doesn't get the throw off in time. Shot clock, violation, MSU. That wasn't Anthony's fault, man. He had to block the ball. Hopefully MSU is smart enough to throw more than one ball here. Kevin Bailey looks like he has a meat shield going. Both players go out. On Grand Valley. Hit out. Four throws. Grand Valley has their players step out, hoping to take it. take the next point in 5 minutes. MSU goes up 1-0. Look for Grand Valley to come out swinging at this point. They're down a point, 5 minutes left. They have nothing to lose. They're going to be looking for catches everywhere. They're going to be looking to make riskier plays here. Catches is the only thing they can do. 2 minutes left. Call timeout. I know.
10. At 10. Because they'll stay at 10. Kevin, hey, if they get above 10, call timeout.
Second set. It's ball game. MSU 1, GVSU 0. First time ever MSU has defeated Grand Valley.